Okay, lovely people. See if I can get you something tonight. Now, I've always been in a position that, the back end fell off. Let's see if I can give you some more supporting data tonight. I've always reached to this bracket, the iterations, that they've changed it numerous times. And this time I want you to take note of the shackle. Take note of that red right there, the red bolt. Nuts on the other side. And the this bracket, the relationship between this and how you just clock down a little bit. Here's the top, but remember the shackle. And right below the shackle is going to be the interface ring. Part of the interface ring is that welded on bracket. All right. So this is identified as the starboard side of the vessel, the same thing. There's that shackle I mentioned with the rusty red look. This is the bottom, and this is where the welded on bracket would be. So the bracket is not presented, is it? The bracket is not there. The bracket came off. All right, the back of this vessel fell off. Now, should the bracket be in the other side there? You know, this also the top that fell off. But this is evidence that the bracket, the ash end just fell off. That's why we don't see it damaged. Now, they heard cracking and everything else. You know, one of these dives, he thought it was the settling of the legs. It could have been one of these fractures. It could have been a fracture of this or the top one I mentioned a few videos back. All right, while I'm here, I want to show you the this piece here, this port rail. It's the starboard rail, this one here. And it's identified as starboard rail. And let's follow it through. Notice that crumpled, bent over, foiled bracket. Rail. Let's identify it as what he says. See how it's inside? Well, that rail was up here. That starboard rail was here. I told you that everything took a spin. And it's sort of, you can see it, you know, almost in a line back here. And then it's out. It's the materials came in and buckled it to that position here when it was in line here at one point. But it made itself inside the vessel. It was on the outside. Let me show it to you. So this is one of my images from a long time ago. There's the other side. That's a different iteration of this. And I kept saying they kept had to improve their brackets. And they're too small. All right. The cantilever effect, the cantilever of this thing coming back to here, strapped at the top of the ring here on this ring in the background. And then connected to this bracket. Look how small it is. This bracket is very small. And it's got to hold all that weight. All right, it's got to hold all that weight. They put a little kicker down here to help hold it by the kicker is a little block. I call it a kicker because the legs have to break free. So this is only side and one on the other side. So you get three connections and the other one's just a kickstand, if you will. This shows you one of the iterations of this system. And there's the bottle. There's your bottle there. It's got the metal liner. This might be V1 version 1, so this might be the plywood bottom. But you see the bottle with the red. It might be aluminum. So let's go from there. If you asked me about lead, quite a few people. They also use lead weights on the skids. Maybe I can run across that image. So here are the lead weights on the skid. And they use the steel Rolodex weights too. This was to help give it strength. They added this black strong back and it works something like this. And then it had a bolted connection at the top strap going into the interface ring right there, which I showed you in a previous video. If it wasn't for that sling, You see the first version of the one of the first versions is a couple iterations, but you can almost see where they bracket it, where they connect it to the interface ring. Interface ring is obviously here, going all the way up, followed all the way up. And it's so close to showing me another detail, but I never get there. So I think this is V1 version 1. You can see that bracket's different in the rear. He's not welding, that's the light he's looking at. I'm using. But what's important are these tabs. They're present in a couple of places. It looks like there might be a tab up there, tabbed here, tabbed there. It's very hard for me to orient myself with the end dome because the tabs are so uniformly placed that I can't tell, you know, if I could probably tell this. You know, if I could figure that out, I could probably tell this which side is what. But these guys might meet the same damn angle. It's so uniformly placed that it's a tough one on that one to be 100% sure. I have to find other witness marks to be able to verify that. But that's the, as you see, like I said, they ground and they ground and they put this welders back on. And remember when they redid the version 1 into version 2, they machined it again. They did take off part of carbon fiber. They put it to a machine and machined it. Now they could have just skimmed pretty accurately the carbon fiber off without taking too much surface of the titanium off. Excuse me. But I imagine the interface ring got thinner as they cleaned the glue off of that with the machining. Now over here we have that strap along the top that they mentioned, and here's the airbag right there. The airbag for people who think doesn't have an airbag. Whatever people. So there's the top. So this top piece right there is indicated right here. They call it the top rail. As you can see, it was on the outside of the ring. Now it's inside. So that's very interesting. How did it get pulled in? Only way I get it pulled in is if they actually fasten into the carbon fiber with this damn thing. Which is amazing. If you could cantilever the okay, so I'm gonna put a line here. This will be this thing here. Just imagine just a single line, and as the forces come in, say they can push here, this has the effect of pushing this way in, and that would be off the interface ring. That would push it in and get us off this interface ring right here, where you see the glue right in that little line there. The glue is right there. That would get us that effect, but it doesn't pull a ring in unless the ring was connected, like I said, into the carbon fiber, which is crazy, you know, putting holes in the carbon fiber. All right, this is that angle. Let me move on. Let's be clear. You see, it's on the outside. It's on the outside on the interface ring. So we have to get, well, the implosion won't push it. Something else has to push it and give it a force to push. And you know, when I say the back fell off, maybe the that would be enough to maybe fell forward to shear it off and buckle it where his hand is. I have to leave this option over magically that they were going nose down, and then this couldn't hold the weight of it nose down, and it sheared the weld off. I show you with the weld missing, so the weld did fail. This is one of the iterations, the last one, and this is a part number. You see, it says how you sling it, 4-point sling. 4-point spider bar is required, so you don't sling it differently. As you can see here, these bolts run through to connect, presently this, but I think they're for the drop legs to be able to disconnect. It's some type of fancy disconnect. using that part number there, I could not locate it. If anyone can locate it with your sleuthiness, your sleuth skills, your sleuthosity, yes, you will win the super reward from me, because I've been trying to find that some bitch forever. On the 4-point spreader bars, you know, zoom in for you, give you the number, and everything else. You kicking my ass. I'm trying to find it. He liked off the shelf stuff, so it's not custom. It's a real deal. One time I thought I had a bad image, and I thought it said part number, and it's a patent number. It's a part number. So that is that bar that we see crumpled. You'll see the end of this torn up. It's bent. So from this is that the end I'm referencing is right here. I'm going to zoom in. It's that. You can see it's sheared, ripped, etc. So there was some connection there. There was some love there. Oops, wrong direction. So here it is here. Nope. It's up top. I always get it, yeah. So it's this one here where it says starboard. And now follow it. You see how it's folded over? Right here it's folded over back upon itself with the, or presents as a huge indent. So you have this, the interface ring. Okay, it was connected to the interface ring. I think it came, it had to deliver it to this place, right? Remember I told you how the two ends come in together, but the right end appeared to have create more acceleration with these two coming together, and that's why the left end has more stockpiled materials. And so the right end comes in with the interface ring on it, and it bends us over before, I guess, going off behind us here. It could be over here, the interface ring. It could be here. They call them segments. Problem is they come up with three segments. They call these the segments, the interface rings. But they identify three segments. So I'm like, in a survey, if you will, of this, I'm like, well, that doesn't make sense. I'm sorry. I call them segments. They call it SGT1, SGT2, SGT2, SGT3. So I'm extrapolating, it means segments with SGT. They did not identify what SGT means inside the legends anywhere. Legends are what you say, you know, your terms, your notes, where you hide the, you know, your definition. Or your extra details you want covered. So this was connected, starboard. Okay, it was connected here. This guy is connected here. We saw that in the image right there. So there's the bent up section. I showed you it was connected at the end, but this is where it was connected here. That's the weld. So this is a weld failure. All right. You can call it a fracture. I call it a weld failure. This is how the ass end drop fell off. All right. This was here. I'm sorry. Let me reverse that. This part was here one time, but now it's underneath. It's tucked underneath. It's inside the ring now. So it went from outside on the ring to there. So do we find it here, the bracket? That would be amazing. They definitely can give us more data, but that's the weld failure. So once again, weld failure. Here's another angle from it. This is your orientation. There's a shackle up top. See the red? And this is where the bracket was welded on. This is why I keep stating, well, further evidence data that shows that it, the back end fell off. you know, it didn't implode. It hit the batteries and pushed this off, including breaking the weld. The bolts, the three bolts they use, held up, and it ripped this thing apart. No, that's not logical. So we've got a weld failure here, and the other side would be interesting, right? So from this angle, looking from the underside of it, there's the where it would be welded. That's where that back end bracket showing you would be welded. For reference, this is the bottom, that little kicker thing I told you about. You find this, you find two of these here, and you'll find two on the other side also. So that bracket, gone. Gone. Oh, so the implosion definitely happened after they lost this the back end, because you can see that this is pushed out. There was no room it would hit the batteries in this case, and then it would fracture the batteries. We would see broken batteries, and that could get us our ripping off. But we have the problem is they bring it out. It's stripped down. It's not even showing the bracket on the one side. The other side is covered up with a tarp. So when you look at the removal of the lens there, when he's inspecting it, you'll see a hole around each one of the spots. These nuts, these bolts they use, these screws, they're screws. If it was a nut on the other side, he'd call it a nut and bolt. But these are screws, and not frankly, they always call them, everybody calls them bolts, right? So we can use either one, but technically it's a screw. You can see it has a center hole. That's just to line it up while they thread it. But it's interesting that it's also, when this is sheared off, what's left is that metal. At least with the photograph, it looks like that this hole is deeper than... it's like the hole went through further, which isn't logical. I'm sorry, I had to repeat myself there. I was recording.